So in this video, we'll be discussing the concept of national income. In my earlier video, I have discussed in brief the topic of domestic income, its meaning. So now in this video, we'll be discussing the meaning of national income and how domestic income is different from national income. So domestic income, as of we should know by now, that it is the income of domestic territory. In that domestic territory, both the normal residents of our country, they are also operating, and the non-residents are also having some institutions which are operated inside the domestic territory of our country. So basically, domestic income was the income of the domestic territory, whether those economic activities are performed by the normal residents of that country or by the non-residents. Okay, so now we'll be discussing the concept of national income. So you all should know that the word nation is itself implying something. National, nation means what? The jurisdiction of your country. As if I talk about India as a nation, so obviously we are having one geographical frontier, we are having some operations, we are having one tangibility in our geographical boundary, but it doesn't mean that India's operation is confined to that geographical territory. Yes, it means that along with the territorial operations and executions, we are having some executions, some operations which we are doing outside the political and geographical boundary of our country. So in this concept, we are moving ahead of that territorial concept, and we'll be studying about the income of the nation, whether it is being operated within its geographical boundary or from outside its geographical boundary. So you should know, if we talk about the world and if we are one nation, so we are having one geographical boundary, which is the presence of our nation on the globe. Along with that geographical boundary of our nation, we are having some other nations also. There are other nations who are having territorial boundaries, they are having territorial space on the globe, and there is even international waters which is present. So now we'll be discussing about national income. So you should first of all know that national income means the factor income of all normal residents of one nation. Yes, this is the factor income, very, very important, factor income of all the normal residents of one nation. If I'm talking about the national income of India, so just practically I want to know what is the sum total aggregate value of all the factor income received by all normal residents of India. Now one thing more we should know, these normal residents, they are having operations within the geographical, or we can say within the domestic territory, as well as they are having operations from outside the domestic territory, and this we call the rest of the world sector or abroad. So our normal residents, they are working inside the country also, and they are having some operations from outside the country also, and we are interested to know their factor incomes of their overall operations from those operations which are there inside the domestic territory and from the operations they are doing with the rest of the world, the factor income which they are receiving from rest of the world. Like I take one example of this, the example will be same as we have taken in the domestic product. Yes, there was one example, profits of Tata Industries. Profits of Tata Industries in India. So we want to know the factor income of all the normal residents within the domestic territory. So these three things we have to consider: factor income, all normal residents within the domestic territory. So here profit, it becomes one factor income. Normal resident, Tata is the normal resident to India, and within the domestic territory, because these industries are having their operations in India, so it becomes what? An operation within the domestic territory. So this is an example. This will be included to find our national income. Now let us move on to one operation which is outside the domestic territory. So now here I will take the example of profits of Tata Industries from America. So now we are talking about the factor income of all normal residents, but their operations are not confined to their country. Now they are having their operations with other countries. So now here profits again becomes what? Factor income. Normal residents means Tata is here the normal resident to India, and because they are having some operations outside the domestic territory, so this becomes the income of the nation. So practically what you have to consider, only two things which are the basic assumptions, like factor income should be there, it should be of the normal resident of whatsoever country we are finding the national income, and third thing, whether their operations are from domestic territory or from outside the domestic territory. But both ways they will be included to find the national income. I hope this is clear. I will take one more example of factor income of the normal resident within the domestic territory. So let us say the salary received by an Indian employee working in SBI in India. Now you need to carefully go through this example. First of all, it is talking about one factor income. Salary received is a factor income. Now who is receiving this salary? Indian employee. So it means what? This is the normal resident to India. Now who is paying him this salary? This is paid by SBI in India. So now this again becomes factor income received by an Indian employee. He is the normal resident to India, and he is receiving this salary within the domestic territory. So it becomes what? It becomes a part of national income. Now let us take one more example of the factor income which is received by the normal resident but from outside the domestic territory. So like we have taken one example here, so I'll just take one example related to this only. Profits of SBI from their operations in France. Now I'm taking one more fictitious condition, but now what we need to do, we need to just remember the concept with the help of this condition, which is obviously fictitious, and these assumptions. So now we are again talking about the profits. Again, they become the factor income of any institution, of any business. SBI. Now SBI is the normal resident to India, but now it is operating in France, which is outside the political and domestic territory of India. If they are operating in France, they have to follow the political decision making of the judiciary of France. But because they are owned by a normal resident of India and they are received by the normal resident of India, whether their operations are from outside also, but then also we will be using this to find this national income. So I hope I made myself clear. National income is just the factor income received by all normal residents. They may be receiving it within the domestic territory and from outside the domestic territory. So now, students, you should be clear with this thing. What is the difference between domestic and national income? You can just go through these videos once again and it will be very clear. So I hope the concept of domestic and national income is clear to you all. And now I will be adding one worksheet along with my video, which will be having some cases, and they'll be asking you whether it will be a part of domestic income or national income. If they are, so what is the reason behind it? And if they are not, then what is the reason behind it? So you all need to do that worksheet. You need to solve it. And if you are having any doubts, you can comment in the comment box also, and you can contact me through my WhatsApp number also. Thank you.